Here we go. Whoa, traffic. Don't worry, we've got this under control.
So word is that the future is electric. Electric vehicles are eventually going to take over the market. And there have been a whole bunch of offerings that we've seen from mainstream manufacturers. I've written a few of them. We'll probably talk about them in the future. But a few months ago, I met someone interesting in Chennai. He's a person from Guwahati who is currently in Auroville. You can see him whizzing around behind there. Parth was telling me about a project he was working on where he was trying to create like this wooden electric dirt bike. What he's created today is like a prototype of prototypes. It's a crossover between a motorcycle and a bicycle, but it's really quirky, it's really unique. And I came down to Auroville today to meet him and to find out a little bit more about the machine that he's created over here. Before we actually start riding it, I'm going to ask him to tell us a little bit about himself as well as what he's created over here and what we can do with it.
Hi, I'm Parth. I'm from Assam. I live in Auroville. I've been living here for 2 years now. I work with schools. I do design thinking workshops. I do consultancy. I work with teachers. I work with students. I'm also very passionate about technology and about working with machines and building things. I love riding motorcycles, driving cars, and that's something that led me to building this. So I'd seen a couple of concepts of these bamboo bikes, both bicycles and motorcycles. Some really beautiful, interesting looking builds, which got me thinking that maybe this is a material that could be used as an alternative material to metal and steel frames. And then I started looking up this entire industry of electric bikes and found a niche in the electric dirt bike segment. And I thought that could be interesting because I live in Auroville and the roads here are sort of semi-on-road, semi-off-road. Long travel suspension just makes sense around here. And I thought, okay, maybe that's a direction I want to chase. So we figured out what are the local materials available. I have a friend who's a carpenter. His name is Chaitanya. He works in Auroville. He runs a workshop called New Dawn. So I worked with Chaitanya and New Dawn. We identified that plywood could actually work in our build case. So we got some 18mm plywood sheets and we started sort of building from there. We had a basic design idea in mind about what the frame should look like. And that's when the real work started, because then I had to identify all the mechanical parts, which is a lot more difficult, a lot more detail-oriented. I started looking at builds that were happening around the world. I spoke to a few people who were doing these kind of projects. I found some really interesting, unique builds, found inspiration from them, spoke to those people, got a list of components that people were already using, which were tried and tested, and then started to chalk out the entire plan around it. So then I had to import a few parts. The frame was built completely in-house, locally. The metal bits were again done locally in a fabrication shop here. The battery again was a complicated part of the build. We had to import the cells and then build the entire pack. And I found a person at Kanchipuram who helped me assemble the entire pack and gave me the right specifications for the motor and for the controller. The good thing about electric bikes is that they're not nearly as complicated as combustion engine motorcycles are. And so even for an amateur, for somebody who's never done a project like this, I thought it would be possible to make this undertaking. So this is strictly a backyard garage build. It's got a steel swing arm. It's got mainly a wooden frame, which is made of 8 sheets of plywood put together for strength and for structure. You'll see a 21-inch motorcycle wheel at the front and an 18-inch at the rear. There are mountain bike components, which is the handlebar and the suspension components, front and rear. The front's got about 200 mils of travel. The rear's got 170 mm of travel. The electrical bits, which are a little bit more complicated, there's a battery which lives here inside the frame, which has 3 kilowatt hours of capacity, lithium ion cells. It feeds power to the hub motor at the rear. The hub motor lives on the wheel, so it's a lot easier to assemble. There are no chains, there are no belts. It's a much simpler assembly. This motor has about 3 kilowatts of nominal power and about 5 to 7 kilowatts of peak power as and when necessary. It's kind of low on power, but it's got enough torque, which is what matters. This seat is absolutely temporary and not really much of a seat at all. So yeah, that's that.
All right, so now you've heard about why this machine was built, how it was built,
And finally, it's time for me to hop on and take it for a spin. This is the power button that comes on. You get battery charge amount, and I assume this will give you the speed. Something about time. It's funny to have like a wooden frame here, but it's really cool. All right, moment of truth.
Here we go. Okay, that's cool. The front does feel a little bit like significantly different from a motorcycle, but what? That acceleration is intense. The nicest thing about any e-bike is that it's super easy to ride and it accelerates like bomb. Whoa, a little bit of a slide there. Just riding into Auroville, I noticed that quite a few people are riding like these e-cycles. Bicycles with a little motor on them that probably make life easier when you're trying to cover a little bit more distance. And this is like an evolution of that. One step up from there, one step below a motorcycle. So, see, that was an electric thing as well. So this gets up to like 40-50 effortlessly, so on a good road I'm sure it does higher speeds as well. It's fairly light and easy to maneuver. This is really fun, man. This is really fun. It's pretty incredible that just a few people can create something like this literally in their backyard. Before anyone asks, this is obviously not street legal. It's not made for riding on like main roads and highways. This is, at this stage at least, a backyard project. And when you have a backyard like this, it's great fun, right? To ride something like this around here. The key is to have a backyard like this and the determination, the inclination and the perseverance to build something like this. Kudos to Parth, Chaitanya and Parth's wife as well, because they're the team that worked together to create this thing, and I'm sure they've had a fair bit of fun with it, and if they create a version 2, it's going to be even more fun. You always learn by doing, and until you've made your first version, you don't know what you'd do differently. So I'm sure evolutions of these are just going to be better and better. I really hope they make more, and when they do so, I hope they invite me out to ride them. This has been brilliant.
Yeah, so this was a fun project. I mean, it was a bit of a shot in the dark in the beginning when we started. I don't have an engineering background, so it was just passion, and I wanted to build my own bike, and so we thought, okay, let's just do it. There are a lot of problems which we need to fix. You'll see that the wheelbase is quite long for a bike this light. The foot pegs, this is basically the swing arm pivot, it's not even the foot pegs. But they need to be lower, they need to be further set, so there's a better reach to the handlebars. So ergonomically, there are a few things that can be fixed, but it's a part of the journey. And there's so much we learned while we were doing this build. And we can take all of that and put it into the next build whenever that happens, which we ideally would like to do in metal, because wood, as nice as it is notorious to work with, and once you made a cut, you cannot go back. There's no welding, there's no fixing, there's no joinery, there's no extensions. It's really difficult to work with. Looks really nice, and so we'll try and keep an element of that maybe in the next build, but let's see. Thank you.
You look worried. Are you worried for him or worried for me?
No, it's the diffuse light and humidity. All right, I want to ride through that.